Good morning, sir. Good morning, sir. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Okay, it's
after. Please sit down. Sorry. Tell me something about yourself.
Sir, I'm Sawan Kumar. I was born and brought up in Bihar. I have done my BTEC and MTEC in aerospace engineering. I have work experience of 15 months where I worked as a head of operation and also as a team leader in another company. Sir, I'm a quick learner and I like to take challenges in my life and think out of the box solution for the problems that I get.
What is the latest learning that you had?
Sir, latest learning, sir, throughout my preparation, it's been more than 3 years that I've been preparing. It has been a continuous learning process, sir, since then.
Okay. What is your optional subject?
Anthropology, sir.
Okay. Why one should study anthropology?
Sir, I decided to take anthropology because it had a syllabus was limited and it also gave me more time to focus on other subjects. Mm-hmm. Apart from that, when I started reading anthropology, I have gained genuine interest in the subject. Mm-hmm. Because it gave me a perspective of different cultures and I have gained skills, for example, more empathetic towards different culture. Mm-hmm. And the term we call cultural relativism, sir.
Mm-hmm.
So it has helped me learn all those things.
Could define culture?
Sir, culture is a complex whole which contains various artifacts, customs, traditions, and it is dynamic, sir. It keeps on changing with times. And it is specific to different communities, sir.
Okay. Have you heard of a term called culture shock?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What is the meaning of that?
Sir, when a particular person from one culture suddenly goes into different culture,
mm-hmm.
and he is not able to mingle with that culture, or when he finds it strange,
mm-hmm.
or is not able to understand the culture and integrate with it, then he goes into a cultural shock. Mm-hmm.
Where have you worked earlier?
So I have worked I was in an e-commerce, mm-hmm. sir, Smart Retail Private Limited.
Mm-hmm.
There I was head of operations, and later I was working with Citizens for Accountable Governance, where also I was a team leader.
Okay, now, and you plan now to come to government job?
Yes, sir.
Will it not be a culture shock for you?
No, sir. I think this role will also be a sort of leadership role, which I have always done throughout my job profile.
Okay. What is your hobby?
Sir, listening to contemporary music and also football.
Why India is not doing good in football?
Sir, there are various reasons for it. One thing I see is, sir, more focus on particular sport. For example, India has given a lot of focus on cricket. So all other sports are little bit behind if you compare it to, sir, cricket. Other problem is, sir, we don't have a large pool of motivators in football who people can look up to. There are only few players that have gained international attention, and I think the big names in, for example, in cricket, we have Sachin Tendulkar. There are many role models that people can copy. So in football, we don't have particular role models that people can look up to. And also, sir, there is a lack of training and also all that infrastructure. We don't have many football stadiums. So these are the various problems, sir.
Okay. Has it got anything to do with the culture?
No, sir, I would not agree with that, because we were doing very well. We had a golden period in football in 1960s.
Mm-hmm.
And since then we have came downwards and not instead of going upwards, sir. So I think it's not because of culture per se.
Okay. What is the performance? How do you rate the performance of ISRO in Indian space?
Sir, ISRO is among the best space agencies in the world. So I think they have done tremendously well. And we are among the top 5 best space agencies in the world, sir.
Okay.
When you completed your graduation, 2013, right?
Yes, sir.
Since then, what are you doing? Only preparing for civil service?
No, sir. 2013, I started working. I was working towards
this. For 2014, I think.
2014, I was working.
Okay. After that, you are just preparing for civil service?
Yes, sir.
Don't you think that as an IITian, we should not invest much of time in pursuing only one examination? You can have a better career after IIT graduation.
Sir, it has taken time more than it should have taken, sir. But I have been on a progressive learning path. And I think I have learned a lot in these 3 years that I have been preparing. And I have been progressing, sir.
What is special in civil services that it is attracting to you despite being IIT engineer and you are giving your best, you are investing your important time?
Sir, civil services particularly is as a job prospect, sir, it is a very stable job.
Mm-hmm.
Also, it is a prestigious job.
Mm-hmm.
Sir, it gives me an opportunity to impact the lives of the people and also towards working for the society, sir.
What was the purpose of setting up IITs? Why you started IITs?
Sir, to take our nation forward in the technology field, sir.
Technology field?
Yes, sir.
And you will take nation forward in administrative field?
Sir, right. Administration also requires technical skills, sir, in that matter, and I think I will be able to contribute.
But it's a specific thing that how your IIT education will help you in actual administration. I'm saying IIT education.
Yes.
What is specific there?
Sir, IIT education has taught me several things apart from just academics, sir.
Mm-hmm.
I was involved in many extracurricular activities, for example, sports.
Mm-hmm.
And it has taught me various levels of interpersonal skills, sir.
Mm-hmm.
It has also developed my personality.
Mm-hmm.
And it has
clear... That is on your part.
Yes,
sir. What is the contribution of IITs? Means how IITs are different than other engineering colleges?
Sir, IITs have better faculties.
Mm-hmm.
They have a much better infrastructure than other colleges.
Mm-hmm.
They have the best talent pool in the country, and everyone learns from everybody else. So that is, I think, the core strength of IIT, that there is such a good talent of people pool that you learn from each other, and that develops a very good interpersonal skill.
That I'm asking.
Yes.
What is that specific anything which you learn from IIT that will help you in administration?
Sir, I think I was able to clear my prejudices that I had in my earlier before coming into IIT. In IIT, I met a lot of people from different states and different culture background.
Mm-hmm.
And that gave me a different perspective towards other cultures and other sort of people, sir. So that was one thing, sir. Otherwise, I was also involved in many leadership activities in colleges. I organized a cultural festival, sir. So that was also a good learning experience. I was involved in football, sir, where I was part of the team. So I also learned working in as a team. These are the various things.
What is governance?
Sir, governance is a system. Governance is a system of working towards the people in terms of policy making, implementation, and also reviewing the implementation, sir.
What is the difference between them, government and governance?
So government is the system which governing, actually. And governance is the structure the details of how the people will be governed, sir.
Okay, the in-depth structure, who are involved in governance?
Sir, we have three part in the system, sir. We have judiciary, we have executive, and we have legislature.
Are there any role of civil society?
Yes, sir. They have a very important role to play, sir.
What is good governance?
Sir, good governance, according to me, will be something which takes the which keeps people at the center stage of every policy making and also its implementation, sir. And also it should bring transparency, it should be empathetic towards people. And
what is the difference between good governance and ethical governance?
Sir, I don't think there is any difference. I think good governance has to be ethical governance, sir.
Because here you are written, you work as a team leader. Name of employer organization, Citizens for Accountable Governance. What is this?
Sir, it was a company that came around in 2013. And it was a campaign management. Basically, they were like a political consultant who were managing the campaign of election.
Okay, they were managing campaign of election.
Yes, sir.
Do you think that it's a right strategy to manage campaign campaigning of elections? Is it a good strategy?
Yes, sir, definitely. I think
means
every party,
the party which is better in marketing is better, according to this view.
Sir, that then it will come about ethical campaigning, and that would be the way ahead, sir. I think there can be fake propagandas to win elections, but then if ethical campaigning is done to make people aware, then it's a good idea.
Okay. Tell me about bullet train, or what heard about the hyperloop train?
Yes,
have you heard hyperloop train?
Yes, sir.
What is that?
Sir, it's a underground tunnel based rail system.
Underground.
Not rail necessarily, sir. Pod system basically. Small vehicles can run into the tunnel, and there is very less drag in it, so it can accelerate to a very high speed. And as the whatever research, sir, I have read, it is very good for the intra-city travel.
Are we doing this type of trains when we don't have sufficient trains, or already we have some structure which is not in good condition?
Sir, I think we should work on both the fronts. We should also keep on improving on the existing structure that we have, but we also should embrace the new technology that we are coming, so that we do not be behind other countries that are taking up.
But on the basis of cost-benefit analysis, the cost we are putting there, is it really effective?
Sir, I think government should bring innovative ways so that there is better cost efficiency in terms of, for example, in bullet train we have taken loan which is at very low interest rate, so that does not put much burden on the finances of the country, sir. So I think it's a good step.
In police organization there are different challenges, right?
Yes, sir.
How can we use technology in police administration and it will reduce some challenges? Can you relate it?
Yes, sir. Sir, I think first and foremost thing about the lacuna in the police administration would be the overburdening of the police that we have, sir. They are overburdened. They are the ratio of the police to the people is very less in our country. So we have to make sure that they are not overburdened, because overburden leads to inefficiency. Then we have to make sure that the police personnel are given proper incentives, sir, in the like for their living condition, their hygiene, everything, and they are taken care of, especially, sir, the subordinate officials of the police, sir. So these are the aspect of the police personnel. Then second, sir, I would see that police should be interference in the working of the police should be eliminated, sir, should be reduced to minimum. For example, security of tenure can be given at all levels, sir, from starting from superintendent of police. So that will be a good step forward. Also, sir, there has to be proper monitoring mechanism, and also we can do ranking of district or administration per se.
Where you will get technology?
So technology can be used, for example, we can have CCTV cameras in all the police station,
mm-hmm.
wherever the FIR is being taken, because there are various complaints that FIR is not registered because they want to improve the, they want to show the higher authorities that there are less cases in. So we can put all the CCTV cameras which
one
are
thing,
being
mm-hmm.
properly monitored. Then we can, sir, also have biometrics, maybe.
Where? How biometrics? You can use anywhere.
Yeah, biometrics.
Even in schools nowadays, they are using biometrics.
Yes, sir. Apart from that, police. So the infrastructure wise, sir, police stations are very ill equipped. They don't have vehicles.
Mm-hmm.
The criminals have much more faster vehicle and weapons. So we need to improve upon that, sir.
Can you tell me district administration structure? Development administration and regulatory administration. We have two type of administrative systems.
Sir, I am not completely aware, but I will try, sir. We have district magistrate at the head
mm-hmm.
of the district. Then we have police, which the superintendent of police heads.
Mm-hmm.
Then we have district education officer. Do we have district health officer? These are all subordinate to the district magistrate who heads.
Have you heard about Jilla Parishad?
Yes, sir. It's an elected body, sir.
Jilla Parishad.
Yes.
Then there is a separate structure of Jilla Parishad administrative agencies. Have you heard about it? JDP CEO, Jilla Parishad CEO.
No, sir.
Do you know 73rd and 74th Amendment Act?
Yes, sir.
What is 73rd Amendment Act? It is about what?
It's about rural governance, sir. Local government, basically.
Okay.
Local government.
But rural or urban?
Rural.
Okay. In according to 73rd Amendment Act,
yes, sir.
There is a three-tier structure. Right. Do you know that three-tier structure? Have you visited villages?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I stay in a village.
You stay in village?
Yes, sir.
You must know that. Because in villages, without that administrative system, we cannot survive. That is the system in which we come across.
Sir, we have a structure, three-tier. First one is, sir, we have the Gram Panchayat level,
mm-hmm.
in which we have Mukhiya and sir, Mukhiya.
What administrative part you tell me?
Sir, there is a ward level officer, Panchayat level officer, which is nominated by the government.
Mm-hmm.
Apart from the elected body,
mm-hmm.
then at the block level we have BDO, block development officer, and
mm-hmm.
parallel body is Pramukh, which works.
That is
yes, sir.
Political. Above BDO.
Then we have subdivisional officers, sir, at the subdivision level.
Mm-hmm.
Then finally we have district administration, which is headed by district magistrate.
Okay.
In between there in Bihar, the decision was taken to declare Nilgais as a vermin, okay, and to allow them to kill, okay, because they were destroying the farms. So don't you think the same decision we can take in the case of street dogs, which have been so much of menace in case of India, that we should declare them as a vermin and should be able to cull them if their population increases? What do you think?
Sir, I do not think that dog has become such a menace in our country, sir.
But there are several cases there between the children and elderly people. The population is becoming uncontrolled.
Yes, sir. There can be further steps that can be taken. They can be sterilized so that the population do not increase. Instead of culling them, sir, we can do the different things. We can put a park where dogs can be separated from the population. We can sterilize them to contain their population. We do not have to.
Then why the same decision was not taken in case of Nilgai?
Sir, I do not know the details of it, sir.
Okay. Can you tell me the three largest tribes in India population is?
Sir, we have Gond tribe, which has very high population. I'm sorry, sir. I'll go through it. I think this is important.
Okay. Okay, tell me, recently there was an incident on Sentinelese Island. There is some Sentinelese people killed a person who is trying to get into the island. And in previous times also they have killed some people.
Yes.
So, do you think so we should allow such type of tribes to remain in isolation? Shall we start assimilation of such tribes into the mainstream society? What do you think?
Sir, Sentinelese Island is prohibited from other people to go in. So whoever has tried to go there is illegal, sir, I think. And they have, these people live in isolation, and they, for their protection, they have killed these people, sir. They have not come into others' territory to kill them, first, sir. Second, sir, assimilation is not, I would not suggest assimilation as an anthropology student, because I think their culture is very unique. And they are not very suitable to our culture specifically. So integration would be a better idea, sir. We can slowly integrate them gradually, because their population is deteriorating because of touch with the outer population. Diseases are going on inside which they do not have cure of. So I think we should slowly integrate instead of assimilation.
Okay. My last question. Why Bihar is... See, India got independence in 1947.
Yes, sir.
So why Bihar remained so backward compared to Gujarat and Maharashtra and all the states? What is the reason that development could not happen in Bihar? That
sir, there are various reasons, sir. First, I would say that Bihar has a very high population density. That is one problem, sir. Another is, sir, we had a huge political instability for 30 years. From 60 to 90, in which there were a lot of chief ministers and changes. So that was a policy paralysis phase where no good governance could happen. Then from 90s, sir, when the country accepted the capitalism and they moved towards promoting industries, then Bihar took a plunge into more socialistic and welfare state, where they did not promote private capital and industries, sir. That was another. And fodder scam, which happened, sir, in 90s, that also tainted Bihar governments. Bihar, as a whole, Bihar was demoralized and people did not want to invest, sir. That was also another problem. But since, sir, in 2005, since 2000, the Bihar is moving forward. And right now, we are...
Have you seen the movie Shul?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so in that movie, what is the climax at that movie? Of that movie, it is basically based on the Bihar society and a Bihar IPS officer. What
yes,
does
sir.
He finally he goes into the parliament, this state legislature, and shoot a politician.
Yes.
So, do you think this type of radical solutions are? What do you think? Do you think this type of support this type of act?
No, sir. Absolutely not. This is against the law. And it will bring anarchy in the long run, sir. I don't think this is necessary.
Okay, so what is the solution? Because there is lack of ethics, and when police officers and administrative machinery is being molded by the politicians
yes.
in a radical way, so there does not seem to be any other solution that these politicians threat your family, threat your children of the police officer. So he takes it as a last step. What is unethical in that thing? So what he should have done in that case?
Sir, I think what that movie portrayed was a thing in the past right now. I don't think the situation actually exists right now in the Bihar, this kind of situation. Everything has improved, law and order has improved.
But if you are on that position of that police officer, what you would have done at that?
Sir, I think I would have done the same.
You would have shot the politician?
No, sir. Like... Yes, sir, because I think protecting my family, and because he did something which was... I would have... Sorry.
Better go
okay.
according to the course of law.
Yes, that would be more appropriate. But
okay, Savan, what is the according to you? What are the problems faced by people living in northeastern India?
So first and foremost, infrastructure bottlenecks that northeast has because of the terrain and geography. Second is, sir, there are so many cultures and so many small communities that there is lack of unity, and there is also regular conflict that comes up, which is hindering the development. Third, sir, we have large porous borders through which infiltration happens, smuggling, and all those nefarious activities take place, sir. That also impinges on the development. Apart from that, sir, I think focus of the central government, now it has increased, but it was very less if we compare in the past. So
what makes you think that the focus of central government has increased now?
Sir, there are few steps that I've taken. Apart from the infrastructure that they have beefed up right now, they have also mandated for example this government that every minister has to visit northeast in 1 or 2 months. I'm not sure of the exact data, sir, but they are supposed to visit the northeastern state every 1 or 2 months, every minister. So they have mandated that. And also, I can't think of anything else.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update from the Unique Academy. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to our channel. Stay tuned.